this is what I'm talking about. The Nigerian government, they don't have any duty of care. They don't actually have duty of care. You can imagine I'm going to Nigerian house now, which I'm walking down. Look at the in the freezing cold weather, which I am going. It's not funny. They don't have. It's only Nigerian government that don't have the duty of care. Can you imagine? In this difficult, tough time all over the world, we're still doing a kind of postal order to go and get a travel certificate. Why can't they allow us to take our passport? Even our passport as we have it, whether expired or not expired, as long as you can, your face shows on the passport, they should allow us to enter the country. I'm walking down the street to Nigerian house this morning. The weather is absolutely cold. In this century, this day and age, Nigerian government are still making it life very difficult for people to come in this difficult weather during this COVID-19. They're still coming down, and then they are making life difficult for the citizenry. That's Charing Cross for you. I'm going to Nigerian embassy now to collect my emergency travel certificate. Yes, you can see as I'm going down. Yes, I'm going to take you close to the door. How sealed, how difficult. They're not going to even attend to people. That's the way I'm going now. I'm just walking down. It's not far from here. It's about 2 minutes walk away from there. See, the freezing, it's already started snowing again. And then instead of them to say, you know what, I had to just travel all the way from my house to this place. It's not a small journey. It's not a small journey. I'm walking down. Hopefully, you will be able to see how the Nigerian build, the Nigerian High Commission entrance looks like. We're going close to the place now. Just watch. I'm walking down. That's the high street in Charing Cross. So to those of you who are planning to go to Nigeria and you don't have a travel, thank God Nigeria is not among the red list countries, about 33 countries which the UK government have blacklisted for its nationals or travelers coming from there. Look at this. We're getting close to Nigerian house now. Look at it. Look at it. Have you seen it? You've seen the flag of your country, of my country. You can see now. It's definitely tough this morning, and every place is deserted. You can see. I'm just going down close to it. I'm not too sure whether they will still allow me. They gave me an appointment for 11 o'clock. You can see. They gave me an appointment. But I'm still, I'll try my help. I'll try an effort. I'll try. Look at it. The whole place is empty. Let me see whether that's the entrance. Look at it. See, that's Nigerian house here. I can show you, see our flag, and right here, hotspot right now. I'm walking close to the place here. It's not that I'm making it up, it's difficult. I traveled long distance to come here this morning to pick up emergency travel certificate. Yet, in my, I don't know whether they will still, I've just gone to the post, I'll show you the video where I went to the post office to buy my emergency travel certificate. I've got my Nigerian passport, I've got my British passport. Yet I can't take visa. The cost of emergency certificate is equivalent of £100. Okay, that is what they have done to for me this morning, and I'm hoping I'm able to get close to the place. There's something that is put on the door here. I might let you read it. Just watch it. Watch all the things that he wrote at the entrance. Whether they will let me come in, I don't know. I don't know if you see, it's a Nigerian coat of arms. In my country, I love it. But yet, everything is very difficult to do. Look at it. Look at the flag there. That's it. God, I'm going down the road. Yes. That's what we're trying to do. We make sure that things, whether they will let me in or not, I don't know. All right, gotta stop now because they might not let me in when this camera in my hand. Okay.